Everyone, this is me, Sadia, here, and I'm doing your first week of February reading. Start from the 1st through the 7th of February 2021. This is going to be for the sign of Scorpio. Let's see what is coming up for you guys for the first week time. I will be adding oracle cards in this reading, but no charms will be added, so stay tuned. And while I shuffle the cards, let me remind you, it's a general reading. It may not resonate with everyone out there. So always pick the messages which are resonating and leave the rest for personal readings. You can always reach out to me on my email ID in the description box. You can also follow me on Instagram, where I do upload daily readings. Let's start the read. Let's find out what is happening for you in the first week time. Queen of Swords. There is a specific someone who you are thinking about. It's more like you are not thinking about that person. It's more of the words that they have spoken to you. You are thinking about those words. Their messages, you might be going through those messages that this person might have sent to you. You might have been going through the, you know, voice notes that they might have, you know, sent to you. I do see that you are thinking about someone because you are reading their texts or maybe seeing their pictures or something along those lines. It's more like, you know, you are trying to figure out a few things, listening to the old messages, texts from a specific someone. It doesn't have to be in your love life, but for majority of you, I believe it is going to be something related to your love life situation. Whoever this person is, somebody who you have been with in terms of relationship. Two of Swords. You are trying to make a decision based on what this person told you. It's more like that energy where, you know, maybe whoever this person is, it doesn't have to be, like I said, it doesn't have to be somebody connected to you in your love life. But I feel like, you know, for majority of you, this person could be somebody who had one-sided love. Like, you know, maybe they had love for you. Maybe you were never interested in them. Now, whatever they have told you, you are thinking about all those things. Be that regarding love life, be that regarding your career situations. Maybe they have always guided you and you never listened to them. Maybe you are going to be like, you know, thinking about them now. But yes, I do see that, you know, you are thinking about what they told you and you are trying to make a decision based on what you have been told by this person. Let's see more cards here. You are feeling blocked right now. You have to make certain decisions and you are missing this person for the clarity, because this person brings a lot of clarity to you. This person is somebody who could be somebody very intuitive as well. It can be a person who is very aligned with the God and, you know, the spirit guides. It's like, you know, it's going to be, you know, it's going to be that kind of energy of a person that you are dealing with. This person is somebody who's very close to the God that they believe in. This person is somebody very spiritual or enlightened being, is what I'm picking up. You are trying to make some decisions based on their knowledge, is what I'm picking up, but maybe you are not in touch with this person right now. You are feeling blocked because you need their help or guidance for sure. Let's see more cards. This person is definitely somebody from your love life situation. Do you feel blocked? Yeah, you are trying to have a clarity around this person and the situation. Ooh, you want to marry this person. You want to marry this person, then what is it stopping you right now? Ooh, you're fond. You want to marry this person, whoever it is. Maybe they have already proposed you, you ignored them, you neglected them, you rejected them. Whatever the case has been, I feel like, you know, now is the time when you are heavily thinking about this person and you are thinking to get married to this person, because now you see the missing links. Now you see the dots are connecting you towards this person. So it's going to be that kind of a week for you. Let's see more cards here. King of Pentacles, the High Priestess, the Lovers. Underneath the deck, Ace of Cups. Yep, you are proposing this person. You are getting married to this person, whoever this person is. Your work had been on your mind lately. Maybe this person stopped talking to you or you blocked them out of your life. Something had happened in this connection. Maybe you are still talking or not talking too much, maybe. But whatever the case is, like, you are heavily thinking about this person or getting married to this person. You have strong love for this person. Maybe you are now realizing that. There's a lot of clarity coming in this connection between you and this person, whoever it is that you're dealing with. Hold on. Let's see one last card. King of Swords. Yep. You had your guards up against this person. But you both are soulmates. King and Queen of Swords. Emperor and the Empress. Yep. You are divine counterpart for each other. And I do see that you are thinking to marry this person. You are not thinking less than that, for sure. you have matured up around this connection. Maybe you were going through some sort of transformation regarding this connection. Especially if the connection, there was a block in this connection because of your work situation. The energies could be completely reversed for some of you. Maybe it's going to be, the energy of the person that you are dealing with as well. Especially if you had been the one, maybe you are thinking of, the words that they spoke to you. Sorry, the opposite way. Maybe they are thinking of the words that you spoke to them, and now they are going to be coming up towards you with a proposal to make. They have been having you on their mind lately, heavily. Why? Because the universe is guiding them towards you. This person is somebody who's very close to the God that they believe in. Like I said earlier, maybe they are manifesting this connection with you as well. Let's see what the oracle has to add to the reading. Let's see. Wow, Scorpions. You have strong passion for someone, love for someone. You're feeling connected to someone. You're feeling pulled towards someone. Self-worth. I'm not going to include that card. Recovery. Like I said, I do see that maybe for majority of you can now connect the missing links. You are now connecting the dots, and those dots lead you towards the specific someone. Whatever that was not sure to you now is being enlightened for you. You are having that clarity now, whatever that was missing. The universe is taking you towards this person. Now you can see that why things have been blocked, why things have been not working well for you. There was something that you were doing wrong, and the universe is bringing you closer to this person. The more you explore it, the more you being, brought to this person in, expansion. I do see you getting aligned to this person. The universe is bringing you two together. The universe, the angels are helping you to come together. There is a strong divine timing happening in this connection between you and this person. Let's see more cards here. Wow. Maybe you were blocking this person out of your life. Maybe you had blocked this person out of your life. Stop chasing people. You deserve better. They might have stopped chasing you. Especially if this is you, if this, masculine energy is yours. If you have been thinking about the words that they spoke, then definitely maybe they were chasing you earlier, but you never listened to them. And now since they are gone, you are now having the clarity around them. Your knowledge, your awareness around this connection is now finally coming to you. You will soon meet the one. Let's see more cards here. Spend time contemplating. For some of you might have been, staying busy with your work, and now maybe you are taking some time off from your work, which is now making you think and contemplate about the past decisions. And like I said, you might be thinking about the words that this person spoke to you as well. So it's going to be the time when you are thinking about the messages that you exchanged, the talks that you had with this person, the conversation that you had with this person. It is opening your mind to a lot of possibilities that you were not able to see through earlier. Everything is now coming clear to you, and I do see that you would be taking action towards this person. Take care of yourself. It's going to be important time for you to take care of yourself. Fire signs for some of you could be dealing with a fire sign as well. Let's see two last cards. Feed the birds. If you have been facing any difficulties, try to feed the birds. It's going to open doorways to abundance for you as well. One-sided love, relax, sorry, release toxicity. The connection has always been one-sided, and I feel like it had been one-sided from the feminine. The masculine was busy with their work situation. The feminine was the one who was into it. The energies could be completely reversed as well. But yes, I feel like there has been one-sided love in this connection, and as the person left, the one who was in love, they left, which is bringing clarity to the other person about this connection. It's more of When they stop chasing you is gonna be the time when you are feeling the love for them. They have always been chasing you, is what I'm picking up. Maybe this person could have been like, madly in love with you, and now you are like, being enlightened around this connection by the universe. So yeah, that's pretty much it happening for you in this week time. If the reading resonates with you, do like, subscribe, and share. If you're willing to get a personal reading, you can always reach out to me for that on my email ID in the description box. Till I do the next reading for you guys, take care. Bye bye.